So far, everything's been fantastic. We've had a great time. I think the festivals have been really organized very well. The crowds have been great, and I think very understanding considering all the chaos that's gone on, you know, over the past year and stuff.
Well, the crowd turnout has been like double what's in the United States, and sicker, just totally slamming the whole time and totally getting into it. I think the crowds here are a lot more diehard than in America, definitely.
Less violent.
Yeah, less violent. Like they let people in with bottles here. They wouldn't let people in with bottles in America, that's for sure. Well, hopefully we'll get our deal negotiated as to where we can record within the next couple of months and hopefully help out Chuck and get everything out, you know, flowing as to where we can do both things at the same time, you know, try to keep productive.
I mean, you know, there's been no pressure from me. I totally support their desires to continue their band because that's important to, you know, get out what the creativity that you have inside you. And I think Cynic's definitely full of a lot of creativity. So, I mean, when it happens, it happens. Right now, we're having a good time, and the tours are going well. And I'm the type of person that just lives day by day, and you know, I'll figure it out when it happens. But it would be great to be able to have, you know, the same chemistry going, definitely. But we'll see what happens.
Is always a little more powerful when you're playing in front of 2,000 people, and you know, it's a lot, you know, it's actually the smaller shows are fun too because you get a lot of raw energy in the smaller clubs when they're packed in real tight. But so far when there's 2,000 packed in together, it's extremely brutal. I think that there's a bigger market over here right now for this type of music, and you know, in amount of sales and stuff, I think we sell as many records in Germany as we do in the U.S. So I think, you know, Germany is definitely the strongest point in, for us. So we like to come over here as much as possible.
The death metal band should always get heavier and faster. You know, just try to be heavier. And that's what we're going to do each album. Heavier and faster. Never fucking wimping, man. Never wimping out.
The better.
Yeah, just sicker in the lyrics, sicker in the album cover. Faster music, harder to play.
Deeper vocals.
Yep. Everything heavier, always going up.
Now we've actually got every member's into what we do. Whereas with Mickey towards the end of Napalm, you know, for him, he was just not into playing really fast. And the four of us, me, Jesse, Mitch, and Barney, we're really into still doing what we do. And so Danny, our new drummer, he's, you know, he appreciates the old Napalm stuff and the new stuff, and he's really into it. So I think they should hopefully, you know, be stable. Well, I mean, the actual clubs we played are really good. I mean, they weren't really, you know, crappy or whatever, but now Napalm's much bigger, so I suppose we have to play bigger halls, I suppose. I mean, I don't know. Just then we used to just arrange our own tours and tour in like a minibus. And we'd never have anywhere to stop. We used to like meet people and hopefully they would, you know, let us stay there. Or sometimes we used to end up at a service station on a motorway, just sleeping there because we had nowhere to stop. And we did that at first, it was really cool. But after a while, we got really tired of it. It was like, you know, you would play, set up your own gear and just like, you know, it was really tiring. And also because we didn't realise how popular we were, promoters or certain people used to like make a lot of money out of us. We used to end up, you know, losing loads of money doing that and getting ripped off. So we just decided to sort of make things a little bit more professional, but at the same time, you know, not go too far. Because at Harmony Corruption, the music wasn't different. It's just the fact of the production and the actual tuning made people hear what we were playing. Whereas before, people were so used to Napalm sort of, you know, sounding like really extreme. As soon as they heard what we were playing on Harmony Corruption, they immediately thought we'd changed, and we really hadn't. And the new stuff's just down-tuned more, and like, yeah, there's more fast parts, really. I might do a side band, sort of like real sort of grungy sort of heavy stuff like Helmet and stuff like that, but nothing really planned. Napalm's really busy. It's like we do this album and then we're going to have like 6 to 7 months on the road again. It's like there's really not much time to do, you know, anything. There might be another Terrorizer EP, maybe, if there's time to do that, but I don't know. Well, this video coming up is Mass Appeal Madness.
We're releasing a new 12-inch or EP, you know, in February, I think it will be out. It's containing 3 new tracks. It's called Pieces, I Wish You Hell, and Carnal Tomb. And also a track from the record Soon to Be Dead, as well as I made a video clip for. That will be quite heavy, you know, with Jesus and everything in it. Well, you know, wearing blood on the back cover was just a thing for the picture, you know. It had nothing with an image to do. We're not an image band, but we want a certain outlook sometimes. And, well, I think blood was just, you know, opportunity for us to try some new pictures, do something more new for us. Not just line 5 guys up, you know, to a wall and picture them. We're so young that a lot of people think we're small kids, you know, and perhaps we don't look that old, but I think we earn some respect for what we're doing. Not because we're young, just because for what we do. I think people shouldn't look, you know, so much to the age of the people who plays. That's not the most important thing. The most important thing in this business is what is good and not. You know.
Also jeder denkt, dass irgendwie Tour, dass es alles nur Fun und so ist. Das ist natürlich wohl wahr. Aber auch Sachen wie, dass der Bus zusammenbricht oder Bremsen kaputt, wie wir letzte Nacht gehabt haben. Auch noch der Vorfall, dass der Manager von Napalm Death total besoffen über sich gekotzt hat, hat etwas damit zu tun. Also wir haben uns mal gedacht, dass mit der heutzutageigen Death Metal Kram, was alles auskommt, dass da das sind zu viele Bands und man muss sich irgendwie unterscheiden und originell sein. Also ich will da nicht mit sagen, dass wir nie originell waren, aber wir haben uns jetzt noch mehr unterscheidet und distanziert von der Death Metal Welt. Es ist natürlich noch wohl immer Death Metal, aber diese Platte ist mehr experimentell und auf unsere nächste Scheibe wird es noch komische werden. Wir werden etwas mehr zu in der Jazz-Richtung gehen. Also wird natürlich noch immer heavy sein. Konzeptalbum ja und nee. Vielleicht textlich, denn all die Texte haben irgendwie mit Religion zu tun. Musikalisch hat jeden Song eigentlich seinen eigenen Stil. Also wir haben uns immer schon für Jazz interessiert, aber ich denke, dass es jetzt heutzutage ist es Zeit für Bands, um sich zu ändern. Ich meine jetzt Death Metal Bands, um etwas anderes zu machen. Und ich glaube, dass die Fans irgendwie das auch mehr akzeptieren heutzutage. Also jetzt, um eine neue Bassist zu suchen, würde für uns ganz schwierig sein, denn der Tony ist sehr gut. Und ein Replacement für ihn zu finden, das würde ganz schwierig sein. Also ich glaube, dass er immer bei uns bleibt als Session Musician. Ich glaube auch, dass das so hört, dass Tony auch in anderen Bands und anderen Musikstilen spielen muss, um ein besserer Basser zu werden.